Hi, today I will brief you about the biochemical role of vitamin K. You heard of vitamin A, B, C, D, E and others. But instead of F, G or any alphabet, it's named K, vitamin K. Here actually K is meant for coagulation. But how exactly, you will understand by the end of video. We know that there are coagulation factors number from 1 to 13. Among them, factor 2, 7, 9, 10 are vitamin K dependent, along with some other factors, protein C and S, structural proteins, osteocalcin, nephrocalcin. These factors are synthesized by liver as inactive zymogens. These zymogens are the product of translation. They should undergo post-translation modification to become active. Vitamin K is involved in this post-translation modification. You are seeing glutamic acid residue in protein chain, naming carbon skeleton alpha, beta and gamma. Gamma carbon already has one carboxylic acid group. This gamma carbon atom again carboxylated in presence of vitamin K, carbon dioxide and oxygen to form gamma carboxyglutamate in protein. This whole post-translation process is called gamma carboxylation of glutamic acid residues. If you observe carefully, gamma carboxylated glutamate has two negative ions because of two carboxylic acid groups on gamma carbon, which essentially combine with calcium to help the process of coagulation. Definitely you heard of calcium oxalate salts. Combination of oxalic acid and calcium ion together forms calcium oxalate salts in your previous classes. The above reaction is similar to it. Totally, we learnt about vitamin K dependent carboxylation. Usually all carboxylation reactions are biotin dependent, but it's an example of biotin independent carboxylation. Search for some other biotin independent carboxylation reactions. If you found any, please put them in the comment box to have a nice discussion. This type of vitamin K dependent gamma carboxylation is necessary for structural proteins, structure of kidney, lung, spleen and bone. As I mentioned already, calcium combines with these proteins to become strong and helps in the maintenance of structure. For example, osteocalcin is a vitamin K dependent small protein synthesized by osteoblasts and seen only in bone. In all these carboxylation reactions, vitamin K undergoes cyclical changes. Before carboxylation, vitamin K is in the form of hydroquinone. On carboxylation, converts into vitamin K epoxide. From this epoxide, it's converted to vitamin K quinone form by the enzyme vitamin K epoxide reductase, where reduced lipoic acid is converted to oxidized lipoic acid. This quinone form of vitamin K is converted back to hydroquinone by NADPH dependent vitamin K reductase, thereby completes the cycle. There is one applied importance of knowing this cycle. The drugs warfarin and dicumeral will competitively inhibit gamma carboxylation system due to structural similarity with vitamin K, which essentially help in prevention of clot. This is whole picture of biochemical function of vitamin K. Thanks for watching video completely. If this video added some values to your studies, please put a thumbs up and click on the red button, that's subscribe button, and also follow our Instagram pages MediPanda and Curious Medico. Help your friends and share this.